public hearing items, and it is T-Text-2024-03. This is a ULDC text amendment, Mr. Billy.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, Commissioners. This is a text amendment proposed by staff thus far. Primarily two main issues, number one being the maximum number of lots accessible from a single point of ingress and egress, and the second being the creation, implementation, and enforcement of a tree bank. The third portion of this is just to give clerical changes to the text. But I'll talk about it a little bit today, but ultimately staff is going to recommend tabling this till your November meeting to allow more time for stakeholders and partners to have some weigh-in on this. I'll discuss it today. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask us now or in the coming month. But we'll start with that access amendment. Right now, the ULDC allows up to 24 lots off a single point of ingress and egress. This has been in place more or less with the International Fire Code. That was changed up to 30 in 2018, 2021, and 2024 during the fire code. It changed to 30. The State Fire Marshal's Office modified it in 2018 from 30 up to 120. So staff has taken a look at that, weighed in based on the State Fire Marshal's Office, the ULDC, International Fire Code, and discussed a couple options here given to you in your packet there, increasing the number from 24 either up to 30, which is the most defensible number based on the International Fire Code, all the way up to 120. We've also given potential conditions if we increase things. We've listed about 11 conditions in here that for your consideration, whether they become de facto with the amendment, whether they become recommendations of conditions, but they're all in your packet right there. We just want to give, again, your consideration for that number. I think with Helene, we've all seen the benefit of having both points of ingress and egress from a safety perspective. So definitely take that into consideration. We will continue to consider it and push this out to our partners, again, for their as well, provide that feedback. But ultimately, we do recommend tabling this text amendment, again, to November 12th. The second point of this main one is the creation of a tree bank. Again, as we continue to develop in commercial properties, we know trees are still there, and trying to put a building in place of a forest isn't always possible. Instead of currently what they do now, getting a variance to the requirements to replace the trees, we want to provide a financial incentive for them to provide into a tree bank that the county can then use to build beautification of Lowndes County for some of our other road projects. So we have a creation of a tree bank that identifies the trees we're trying to save and the steps in order for the development community to take if they cannot meet the current code to replace all those trees. So those are the two main amendments, and again, that third one being the clerical errors and just updates. I'll stop there for any questions, considerations at this time.
Any questions for Mr. Dillon? Okay. Hearing none, we'll move